Thank you very much, Carol. We love you.
Everyone, we're trying to have all of us a good time in this merry, merry Christmas, trying to have a holiday fun. And look, these are presents that were given to us. Dave is asleep because he has a nighttime job and he didn't make it to the show, so he's gonna miss, but Tornado's gonna be the special gift giver. So let's open these presents now and see. We have a great show for you guys today. We have Gonzalo. Here's Gonzalo personally, and here is a little fetish item he gave me. It's so cute.
Isn't that
cute.
Great?
Isn't there kind of a similarity? I think it's really cute. Yes. Oh, hi, you guys. Yes, no, I can't hear you. Philip's talking to me over the headset, and I can't hear him. Also, you guys, can you put all the calls right through today? There's no censoring of calls today.
You look just like Madonna.
Yeah.
Oh, I have a call.
Madonna wants to look.
Hi. Oh, hi. You're on air. Happy Christmas, or I should say holiday.
Well, you should say Happy Hanukkah.
What?
Happy Hanukkah.
Oh, thanks. Are you Jewish?
No, I don't know why I'm Christmas.
You don't. You're just trying to balance out peace and beauty.
What?
On Friday night?
Where were you?
Where were you? I can't hear you.
You blacked out?
Listen, wait a minute. We can't hear you. We can't hear you.
Tom?
Oh, there we go.
What's your name?
My name's Tom.
Tom.
What's your last name?
Chum.
Oh, well, I, yeah.
It doesn't ring a bell, huh?
No, but...
I must not have been where you were.
What's the difference, Tom?
Huh?
Oh, let's open the presents.
Golf cart. Okay, now what do I do here?
Just open. No, these are for us. These are for the crew, for all of us. This was shit. Well, thanks, Tom, for calling. If you want, you know, call in later. If you send us a really good idea for television, we'll send you a special. Where am I? A special MVTV.
All right. Look at what I got here.
Oh, yes. Charlotte, you have to point. Okay.
Right.
It's two walk-ins,
man. Listen, Charlotte, you got to point at which camera I'm supposed to look at, because it's so bright in the studio. I can't
too
see a thing.
Cool. This is
let's put them on. Let's put them on.
Yeah.
Put them on this battery. Okay, now listen.
This is terrific. Oh, they're washing.
Well, listen, you know what? I just got a cue. It's time to go to Tyler. Here is, you guys, listen up. Everyone, round the Christmas tree.
Nobody is included.
No, there's batteries in the backs. Okay, here we have is Tyler Davidson. And Tyler Davidson is a professional shoplifter. No. I hope that key tape, the burning flames of hell, aren't going to come up too soon for you. But, Tyler, you know what? Dave was going to do the interview, but he's asleep. Oh, camera two. There we go. Why, Philip? Tyler, do you have any moral problems with shoplifting?
Getting caught is a moral problem.
Getting caught? Uh-huh. How many times have you gotten caught?
Actually, never.
No. Never. Uh-huh.
Probably after the show I might get caught.
So, aren't you frightened of showing your face in public that this is like actually like the police could say, aha, or you have to be caught in the act so it doesn't matter?
Well, I'm in a disguise.
Oh, you're a disguise. Uh-huh. Yeah, I know. I didn't recognize when you came in. So, why don't you tell us about some shoplifting techniques?
Shoplifting techniques,
yeah.
Huh?
I mean, I used to do the big poncho, but they're out of fashion, so it looks really obvious.
You want a booster coat, maybe some leather or something. Cut a hole in the pocket. Inside pockets work great. Stick the thing in, you can walk right out the door. And they can't actually even arrest you until you get out the door.
Yeah.
Otherwise, you can, you know, you can sue them, because actually, they're not like police. They don't have any rights to arrest you.
So basically, you pretend, the best thing to do is to pretend that you're shoplifting, but then not shoplift, and then
right,
you get stopped
right
by them, and then you can sue, like, the store.
It's magic, right.
Uh-huh.
False imprisonment, false arrest, emotional pain and suffering.
Wow. How much money have you been able to get out of that kind of practice?
You know, it all depends on the lawyer you get.
Yeah, so you need it. So, and also I guess if you're like a white boy, you know, I mean, a black guy's gonna have a harder time defending himself than in our society, but anyway. So, now how about this return policy situation? How can I get myself some, like, stereo equipment?
Just grab a receipt, you know? Steal some receipts. Write yourself up whatever you want.
Yeah.
CD players, amplifiers, even needles, you know, if you're old-fashioned, you have a phone.
Mm-hmm. Oh my God! And what items have you shoplifted already? What's your mother getting?
That's a secret.
Okay. What other items? What other items have you gotten shoplifting, and how'd you get them?
Basically, just through cunning, you know.
Yeah.
And everything I'm wearing right now, I'm shoplifting.
Yeah.
Spring, watch, clothes.
Clothes.
Wig.
Yeah, yeah. But you know, you're a young guy. I mean, wouldn't like an old person disguise, you know, like, or like a handicapped person disguise be a much better one? Because, you know, as you said, like, people are avoiding looking at you and stuff, but, you know.
Well, you know, just whatever suits you when you wake up, however you feel.
Yeah.
That's just what you put on.
So what's the easiest store to shoplift in the Bay Area?
I'd say, it used to be Macy's. I'd say now Nordstrom.
Nordstrom.
Right, because they're new in the area. Yeah.
They don't want to seem like they're the big brother watching you. Like, they don't trust you.
They are watching.
Yeah, I know, because in Nordstrom, like, for the lingerie, they don't put any of those magnetic tags. And you go in, and they don't count how many bras you have or underwear, you know? And you go in, there were, like, 13. I mean, you know how many bras and underwear one can wear. But not that I do it, but I'm just saying, whereas Macy's, hell, they put that magnetic thing on every little, tiny little G-string they sell.
Really?
Yeah, yeah. And Macy's changed their fur coats together, whereas Nordstrom, I don't think they do.
Bolt cutters will get right in your shoes, no problem.
We got a call. Tyler, I hope it's not the police recognizing you. Now, you wrote a long article in the Nose. You wrote a long article in the Nose about this. So if you, okay, so just to wrap up now, if you want to hear more about shoplifting or read about it, rather, take your favorite issue of the Nose to your bathroom, sit on the toilet, and read all about how you can save this Christmas. Hi, you're on air.
Yeah, why do you think shoplifting is all right? If it was your store or your house, you wouldn't like it.
Well, I'm not going to morally defend shoplifting. I'll leave that to the professional. Tyler, you want to answer that or not really?
Yeah, where do you live?
San Francisco. Where do you live? What planet?
What planet? What planet do you think I'm from? Maybe Venus.
Uh-oh, I think we've got a... Well, listen, you know...
Another thing is, how come nothing ever happens on your show?
Do you like to watch the microwave really close when you're cooking?
That's a hostile call.
Well, shoplifting's not a good
watching?
Thing. Shoplifting's a bad thing. It's not a good thing. That's what this guy does, and they're just showing it here.
Yeah, look, we're just giving it a take.
Like, I don't agree with it.
Okay.
I never admitted to shoplifting.
Okay,
right?
Okay. It's time for... He never admitted to shoplifting. It's just a joke. Is David here, Chris?
It's not me.
Where is David?
I have it.
Okay, Gonzalo will go. Go, Gonzalo. Okay, you're on, Gonzalo.
Well, I need a close-up. Thank you for tuning in into this program this past year. And I won't be here for New Year's Eve, so today I want to thank everybody that participated in creating this program, from the director to the people that works in the camera and the janitor that cleans the studio afterwards. And it's been quite an experience to be sharing this half hour with all these people. And it's actually a great, great experience to have this time and be communicating with people that you will never see their faces. But anyways, you know that they are there. So we're gonna say goodbye to 1990. And though many things are happening that they don't supposed to, this is supposed to be a decade in which people have the opportunity to understand one to another, and it's not happening. You see what is happening in the Persian Gulf, and we're taking care of business, which are not ours, actually. defending these people that are getting richer every time. And I consider myself a person that doesn't like at all fighting or aggression. So I plead that the troops come back as soon as possible and we start preparing our Olympic team to go to Barcelona in 1992. Instead of asking for money on television in order to prepare these people, instead of asking money in order to send people to school, in order to get an education, a mediocre education, because they don't even put an emphasis in raising the salaries of the teacher in the United States. Nobody wants to go into the field. So I'm pleading that, please, the troops come back soon. These people they have no idea what they're fighting for. The American flag is dressing on dark brown and green, and it's full of dust, and it doesn't make any sense. So let's get together in the end of this year and celebrate somehow the opportunity that we have to share this time here, instead of being in a conflict. Prostitution is very high in Russia. Gays are not allowed to express themselves and show who they are. In Chile, Augusto Pinochet is getting kicked out of the army because he's been stealing money for the past 17 years. That's it. I don't have anything else to say.
Oh, God.
I got it.
Oh no, you can't keep that. That's an MVTV present. No, no.
One, number one.
Number five.
Pick up your microphone.
Five. I'm sitting on
number five. Who has number five? Am I who you're talking to? Anyway. Hi, Wes. You have five. Five's in the booth. Okay. 13. 13. Who has 13? Is that in the booth also? Chris.
Oh, come on, Chris.
Come on, go open it. Show us what you got.
Yeah.
About the way. Number 14. Number 14.
Because you can stay home and watch Godfather movies and get drunk on scotch.
We do that when we're not here.
You know, that's what I think I'm going to do for Christmas. I'm going to stay home, I'm going to write Godfather 1 and 2, and then go to the opening matinee of Godfather 3.
Everybody's going to do that. Everybody's going to see Godfather. It'll be great. 14. Number 14. 14. 6. 6.
Isn't that a movie?
Two, here's two.
Hello?
Hello?
Hi.
Hi. Hi, how are you guys?
I'm okay.
I'm tense.
Well, I just wanted to wish you all a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Well, listen, why don't you get a gift? What's your address? How can we find out your address? Why don't you call right back and give us your address, and we'll send you a gift, okay?
All right.
Okay, cool.
Sounds good.
Uh-huh.
Well, I'll send us a gift.
Okay, all right.
All right.
Okay, call right back.
Okay, bye.
Okay, she'll call right back, Philip. Let's go to the Kuchar tape. This is Christmas 85, a George Kuchar tape that was re-edited in 1990, and it's a really moving, epic display of George's and his mother's relationship. It's really pretty exciting. So let's load that tape and roll it, Philip.
What number do you have?
Two.
That's Christmas with George Kuchar and his mother. I hope you like it.
Six.
It gets kind of cold when the sun goes down, huh? It is kind of cool. Well, the sun is shining. It's beautiful. Well, what do you expect this time of the year? It's winter.
Too bad they didn't turn the Christmas tree lights on at Pier 39. Oh, there it goes, Ma. The lights just went on.
Blackie stayed home again when Mom and I went downtown to see the tree at Union Square. She had sweet dreams while Mom and I battled those lousy crowds in Woolworths. And then we had to tackle Knob Hill.
Well, this way you'll work up an appetite, huh?
Yeah.
That Connie Seliger plays a manager in, she got in trouble with the producers because they said her ass was getting too big. I wonder if James Brolin has a fat ass.
This is my ass. You think that they kicked me off the show too? I bet they would.
Your stomach is empty. You're probably hungry.
My stomach hasn't been empty since you got here, and you know that. So what are we having for Christmas dinner?
Well, for Christmas dinner, you're going to have southern fried chicken, chicken legs, and you're going to have a cup of split pea soup, cauliflower, and then we're
going to
have...
onion something or other. Yeah. You like it?
Yes, very good.
You going to leave me a piece or what? Your feet hurt today from the walking yesterday up Knob Hill?
Not too bad. I was surprised, you know. Usually they ache for a couple of days, but it doesn't bother me.
Okay. Well, thanks for doing all that work in the house for me.
Well, that's okay. I do it because I want to do it for you, because not because you...
slobs?
Huh?
Not
no.
Because we're slobs?
No, not that.
Exchange. Hi, you're on air. Hello.
Just want to get something.
Yeah, okay. Hey, David, what's your
Wes?
Open it up. Everyone, show
okay,
your presents.
Now,
five. Who's got five?
Two.
Oh, Scott. Scott up there has got five.
Uh oh.
Ten.
Explore with energy.
Wes?
What?
Uh oh.
Thanks, kiss
me.
Shh. Everyone,
it's a true detective.
Thanks.
Yes, caller?
Ten.
Eight. I have one of those.
She's
gone.
The
go-go girl being
eight.
Headed.
Madeline? Oh, eight. Me. Yeah, okay, listen. It is 15. Now. Okay,
wow.
Wait. Wow.
15.
I don't know who has 15. Listen, it's time for Susan and Susan.
Susan and Susan taking time out from their
so busy performing schedule to grace us here today. Ready to hit us with some wonderful holiday recipes and Christmas cheer. Ladies and gentlemen, please, please get ready to welcome those lusty brunettes, Susan and Susan.
Really? Oh, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Happy holiday.
Happy holiday.
Happy Hanukkah. Oh, did you get any on you? Froilich Keys, Fine Octane.
Feliz Navi, Felix's Navel.
What?
Season's greeting.
And Happy New Year. Whoa, let's not get ahead of ourselves there.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Susan.
And my name is Susan. We're Susan and Susan, and we're back in town. Just in time for Madeline's holiday Christmas special.
We took a break from our round of holiday parties in Frisco. I mean, I've been going to some holiday parties. Maybe you've been staying at home.
Well, I've been going to some holiday parties myself.
Anyway, you know what really gets my gander up?
Whoop, is your gander up?
No, what irks me to no end is that these holiday buffets, one simply cannot get a decent wiener.
Or for that matter, something to eat that's got some git to it. Now, as performers, professional performers people, we come off the stage, we like a hunk of protein or a hunk of meat or what have you. Believe me, you, I'd like to know what you have.
That's not what they're serving at these holiday buffets.
No.
I've been there, and the food they're serving is little.
It's bad.
And it's from Europe.
I mean, I don't know what it is with people being cheap these days with their tiny foods and mineral water.
Mineral water? I said fill her up. I thought it was vodka. I could just spit.
Oh, this clean and sober thing. Where's it gonna end? I mean, we've never followed it, and we're still here.
I don't want to be made to feel guilty for my goddamn martini.
That's right, people. I mean, this clean and sober thing, like I said. You know, people, you just can't keep going with this kind of stuff. I mean, people, you gotta know your limits. I, for one, know mine, but if we harken back to a Christmas of, I won't say the year, my dear, but I do remember a very good friend of mine, I won't say her name at this point in time, tossing her cookies across a very crowded lounge at a very important engagement in Oxnard. God knows what it was you'd eaten.
Speaking of food, what are we on this show for anyway, Susan?
Okay.
We're here to show you people our special holiday recipe hint.
That's right.
Here it is.
Here you go.
Easy cheese. It's easy, it's cheap for most of you holiday party givers that are.
Yeah, and it's you're not going to spend all your time in your kitchen preparing it, and technically speaking, it's not even food. So you're not going to get sick on it like you would if this cheese happened to be from some French goat.
You can trust this, people. If you really want to put on the dog for your holiday parties, you just put this on some crackers.
Okay, get the crackers.
Where are the crackers?
Well,
Susan, where are the crackers?
Where are the crackers? Did you leave out the crackers?
Did you leave them in the cab?
Did you leave them in the cab?
No.
Well, if you hadn't been hanging on the driver all that time, maybe you would have remembered.
Find the crackers.
What are we going to do without crackers, Susan?
Oh. It's a finger food, people. You just squeeze some on there. Your cheese. You just go ahead and use your finger food there. Mm. Oh, that's not bad. Mm, it's not bad. You got your cheddar. Kind of spicy.
Oh, I got your nacho. It's kind of tangy.
Well, now here.
You can mix them and match or do one at a time.
Whatever you enjoy, people. Now just remember.
Your guests are just gonna love this.
Yeah. Oh, hey. What?
Susan.
Okay, people. Just remember, it's easy, it's cheesy, kind of like us. Hey, we gotta go. We got another holiday party to attend.
Oh, so long, folks. But just remember, at your next holiday party, don't forget your can
of cheese.
Good night, ladies and gentlemen.
Good night, Susan and Susan.
Oh, that was so much
fun. Good night, Susan and Susan. I have so many things to hold, everyone. You guys, stay on. Did Susan and Susan get their secret surprise Santa gift?
Oh,
well, is there a secret surprise Santa gift? Is there a 10? Is there a 10 in the crowd? 10? Here's 10, you guys. Here's a gift for you guys.
Oh,
14. 15.
Madeline,
oh, 15. Oh, thank you. We got a call, David.
Oh,
who's this? Who's 15? Oh, they came.
Hey, guys. That's Tom. Oh, my God.
Oh. Jeannie, Mika, did you get a... Did you get a... did you get a present, Jeannie? Oh. Here's this one, number 8.
Big
Daddy and Roth.
Big Daddy.
Oh, look,
blow this up.
Can I see that?
There we go.
Wow, who got this?
Big Daddy and Roth.
Right.
Wow. And I got this present from Gonzalo.
Now, I don't know
hey,
how these
David,
rubbers exactly
what did you get?
I got these.
Gonzalo, what did you get?
Susan, I think we need to blow these.
Oh, weird. Yeah, those are great. They're kind of weird, though. I've read some.
Oh, no, these
well,
are...
Well, you started to have a chat.
Wait, we got a caller.
No, this isn't the way. No.
Hi.
Hey.
Oh, he's heard the story about I bought this hat at Woolworths and I was leaving and they ran after me and made me show my sales.
Oh, this is exciting. I don't know. Tornado's having some kind of private conversation with one of her car moors. I'm not sure what's going on. But here's Gonzalo. And this is everyone is at home because, you know, Christmas is really a family time. And so, you know, I decided to stay home with my boyfriend instead of go home to my mother. And she gave me a lot of grief about this, you guys, okay? But I just wanted to share all that little, that trivia part of my very personal life with you.
Thank you, Madeline.
I think I missed her.
Of course, Dave.
You didn't like her head?
No, she wanted to stay home with her boyfriend instead of visiting her mom.
I know.
Something moms never appreciate.
No, Dave's gone.
My mom wasn't too thrilled when I decided to stay home with my boyfriend either, so.
Oh. Well, but you're going to have a really nice time.
So I shot her right between the eyes.
Aw, Mom.
Okay, well, I gotta go. I think my cookies are burning.
Okay, well, okay. Put them out.
Okay.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Oh. Dave, as you can tell, is sweating because he ran here all the way from where he lives in NB versus... Christmas without you. I know, Dave, you've looked better. Because you're always really great looking, but today you're looking a little... No, you're looking a little, you're a little apart at the seams, shall we say. Dave, there's a call. Dave, there's a call.
Hello, telephone caller.
Yes, I feel that you should guard your cheese.
Guard our cheese?
Oh, the cheese! Susan gave us
I've
some
got
cheese.
It's pretty safe here. I've got a good grip on it.
Well, listen,
I
this
like
is a very informal show today, and basically we're all...
It's easy, nacho news size, better value,
all
at least.
Have you met all of us at MVTV? Have you met all of us here at MVTV?
Have you met all of us here at MVTV?
I'm Madeline, and
she's
here's
Madeline.
Gonzalo. See, you've met him all.
I have a Madeline, have some tasty cheese.
Oh, ooh. Some what cheese? Oh.
Tasty cheese.
I know. Oh, this is the guy who sticks it up his butt and then squeezes it. Oh, my God.
Are you the guy who sticks it up?
Oh, I knew it.
Are you the guy?
I'm so glad you finally called.
Is that you?
So what's your name again?
What's your name?
Oh, I guess he had to go stick more cheese up his butt. Listen, why don't you show Sputnik with the Fisher Price, the other crew members. Did you guys all get gifts, Charlotte?
Yeah.
Sweetheart, now look at everyone. There's Charlotte. That's Charlotte there. Charlotte, Sputnik, Sputnik. Sputnik, Charlotte. Charlotte. She's over there. Well, you know, in the studio, there's often like three generations of communication, like telephone, you know, so it's hard to meet. Well, now it's blank out there. I don't know what's going on. That's Santa. That's not Charlotte. But listen, whatever your cheese needs are for the season, I do hope you eat a lot of food and drink a lot of alcohol.
Don't forget your vegetables.
Oh, the vegetables.
Happy holidays.
Have lots of split pea soup for Christmas.
Bye. Bye. Happy holidays.
Hello? Lael? No, Lael. Hello? Hello, Philip. Oh, yes, I can hear you. Hi, Philip. Well, there's a call. Lael, can you put... Yes, I can, Philip. Well...
Holy infant, so tender and
okay. This is MVTV, over and out. Bye.